makes it much easier to do it here than in my office. On behalf of the flag as well.
The present round of enlargement is probably the most important in the history of the European Union, because it will end the artificial division of Europe that was a result of the Second World War, and it will give us the opportunity to project the same level of political and economic stability that we have already achieved in the present European Union to the whole area between the Baltic Sea and the Black Sea that was under communist rule for decades. So it is a peace project politically.
Language is everybody's allowed to speak their own language, all the documents are translated.
What made the present round of enlargement so unique was the fact it was not only preparation for membership that we have done. At the same time, these countries were in a process of political, economic, and social transformation of a kind that we have never seen before in the history of Europe. And the methodology that we have used was completely new, because negotiating, that was only a part of the project, and not the biggest part. The biggest part of the project was to support these countries in their efforts to meet European standards, European and European rules. And I must say that was a very successful project, and the fact that the new member states are already now modern democracies, open societies, and functioning market economies is first of all a result of their own efforts. They have done that. But it is also a result of our support and our cooperation. What the new member states will bring is a new dynamism, new dynamics for the process of European integration. Especially the young people in these countries know exactly that their own future is closely linked to the future of European integration. For them, Europe means future. For them, Europe means individual chances to create conditions of life which are much better than the conditions of life for their parents and grandparents. So they have a very, very strong interest to see Europe developing and improving. The other element that they will bring is, of course, economically. These countries are emerging markets. They have very robust growth rates, and all the other European countries benefit from that, because the growing markets in these countries offer very important trade and investment opportunities.
It's not yet announced. I do not know exactly what's going to happen.
And I just read today.
I feel a deep satisfaction here. This was a very difficult project. The odds, let me say, were not very good when it started. That it could be done in such a relatively short period of time. So I feel really, really satisfied that it was possible to do the job. And I'm in a position today that I can say mission accomplished. But on the other side, of course, I'm a little bit nervous, and you can compare my feeling with the feelings of the coach of a football team that is performing for the first time. And of course, the coach must be nervous whether his team will now show what it has shown in the training camp so successfully and beautifully.
A big festival is more or less a political event.
It seems like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Das bedeutende Ergebnis, das wirklich historische Ergebnis dieser Erweiterung ist, dass damit die künstliche Teilung Europas überwunden wird, die das Ergebnis des Zweiten Weltkriegs war. Und das bedeutet, dass das europäische Friedensprojekt sich einmal mehr bewährt hat. Und das bedeutet gerade für Deutschland, dass an der ganzen langen deutschen Ostgrenze Frieden, politische und wirtschaftliche Stabilität für lange Zeit gewährleistet ist, und der Vorteil, der darin gerade für Deutschland liegt, ist mit Geld überhaupt nicht auszudrücken. Es gibt aber nicht nur diese enormen politischen Vorteile, es gibt auch sehr starke wirtschaftliche Vorteile, und Deutschland profitiert von den schnell wachsenden Märkten in Mittel- und Osteuropa mehr noch als andere Mitgliedsländer.